So here's a joke that engineers like to tell each other about the profession. A priest, a lawyer, and an engineer are scheduled to be executed by guillotine. The priest is first, and he puts his head on the chopping block. The executioner pulls the cord, and nothing happens. "Divine intervention," cries the priest, "you have to let me go." So they let him go. The lawyer's next, his head's on the chopping block, the executioner pulls the cord, and again, nothing happens. "Double jeopardy," cries the lawyer, "you have to let me go." And they let him go. So now it's the engineer's turn, and he gets up to the chopping block, and just as the executioner is getting ready to pull the cord, the engineer says, "Wait, I think I see your problem." Engineers tell this joke to each other as a way to play up a stereotype about engineers as altruistic, willing to help, and it also means that we're so focused on the technical aspects of solving a problem that we don't recognize our social surroundings, and we don't have a critique of what's happening around us. So as an engineering educator, one of the things that I try to do with my students is help them align their values with what they're learning in the classroom, to help them not think of engineering as purely objective, but to realize that engineers operate in social settings and that the technologies that we create are impacted by society just as much as they in turn have social impacts. Social justice is a very difficult thing to define. It's much easier to define social injustice. And one big question that social justice advocates might ask is who gets to define what social justice is? So social justice then ought to be defined by people who are experiencing injustice. And that might lead us to a set of issues where we could juxtapose engineering and social justice and begin to ask, how is it that engineering has contributed to different kinds of injustice in the world? And if we ask that question, one of the first things that might come to mind in the United States in particular is militarism. When you think about a list of the top employers for engineers in the country, and you think about the top list of defense contractors, there's a lot of overlap between these two lists. Engineers are heavily involved in developing military technologies. Second, we might ask about engineers' involvement in corporate America and in serving profit motives over people. And third, we might think about who is allowed to do engineering and who is engineering done for. When we ask who does engineering, we're reminded that engineering has, for decades, had a problem of underrepresentation of both women and minorities in the profession. So once we've enumerated all of these ways that engineering can contribute to injustice, it's important to remember that it doesn't have to be this way, that in fact, the profession of engineering has great potential to work for social justice ends. And one of the ways that we might think about doing this is to look at other professions and see what lessons we might learn from how they operate. Social work is a profession that has organized itself around social justice as a goal. And we've seen even in more traditional professions like medicine and law, there have been movements within those professions. In medicine, for example, thinking about public health and thinking about access to medicine among those who can't afford medical care, and thinking also in the case of law, there's both legal services, which extends access to the profession to others who might not otherwise afford it, or we think about public interest law, which serves social justice ends. In engineering, we might similarly think about what would public interest engineering look like, or how could pro bono engineering allow those who cannot otherwise afford engineering to experience some of the benefits of engineering. So we might imagine a tradition in which engineers do pro bono work and begin to serve other communities. We're starting to see a trend in the United States where engineers are forming nonprofit organizations to do work for communities that are suffering from poverty, lack of access to clean water and energy in communities both in the United States and around the world. Another way that engineers can contribute to social justice is thinking about national priorities and actually getting involved in the public debate about those priorities. Right now, we're seeing a conversation about whether we might decrease our defense spending as we pull out of the wars abroad and think about increasing spending on green energy as a way of creating jobs and spending money on restoring our infrastructure. These are two areas where engineers can be heavily involved in the design and construction of new projects. Another way that engineers have been involved in the fight for social justice has been in corporations where they're working. One thing that engineers have done is blown the whistle when they have access to information that they believe the public ought to know. But there are other forms of working for social justice in corporate settings that might also be effective but less dramatic than whistleblowing, that is, working for change from within. My hope for my students is that they will ultimately be able to find jobs that align well with their values, and that those students that are committed to social justice can find opportunities that are outside of the status quo of serving either military or corporate ends, and allows them to fulfill their commitment to build a more socially just world.